Good evening to all of you. This is our first lecture on programming with C. So before beginning our session, we should understand the tools that we require to execute and run the program of C. Okay, so we need a compiler like Turbo C, which will compile our program and which converts a high level program into a low level program, which is understandable by the computer machine. As we know, computer understand only one language, that is called binary, 1 and 0. So compiler is the tool or a program which converts any high level language program into a machine understandable code, that is called as object code. Okay, so it is, you can say, a translator, a intermediator which converts one language to another language and the another person can understand that language. So in case of computers, the language that computer understand is only binary 1 and 0. So we have another program or a tool which compiles your program, that is called as interpreter. So interpreter is a program which compiles your program line by line. If you compare compiler with interpreter, compiler compiles the whole program at once, gives you a list of errors, and you correct the errors and you again recompile the program. If it successfully recompiles the program, then you can go for execution. But in case of interpreter, it compiles the program line by line. Okay, so if there is a line at a particular line, say line number 5, error at line number 5, it won't allow you to go to line number 6 till you correct the error at line number 5. So that is the difference between compiler and interpreter. Interpreter compiles the whole program line by line, whereas the compiler compiles the whole program at once. Okay. So what do you mean by a program in computer programming languages? Program is a set of instructions given to the computer machine to perform certain task. To learn any programming language or any language like Hindi, Marathi, English, we must understand the grammar of that particular language. Similarly, to learn any programming language, we must understand the grammar behind that language. So what the grammar consists of in any programming language? It consists of all the alphabets, all special symbols, words, paragraphs, etc. Okay. Now, in any programming language, every program has three steps. Every program goes through three steps, that is input, second is process, and the third is output. So input is where we actually give the input required by the program. In process, we actually give the logic, or we develop the logic, or we write certain formulas to process it. And then at last, we have output section where we actually print the output of the program. Now we'll go to the understanding of grammar of C programming language. The grammar of C programming language consists of the points such as variable, constants, identifiers, keywords, data types, etc. Okay. Now we'll start with the concept called as variable in programming language. What do you mean by a variable in any programming language? Variable is a memory location used to store a value, right? So variable is a named location into the memory, computer's memory, used for storing certain value. The name of the variable is given as variable because the value of variable can be changed at any time during the program execution. The value of the variable varies, that's why it is called variable. Then we have another term called as constant. What do you mean by constant in a programming language or any program? Constant is a special variable whose value cannot be changed during program execution. It means that the value of any constant variable remains constant throughout the program execution. Then we have a term called as keywords. What are keywords? Keywords are nothing but the reserved words, predefined words, whose meaning is known to the compiler in advance. Whose meaning is known to the compiler in advance. So Keywords are nothing but the predefined word whose meaning is known to the compiler in advance. We need not have to tell the compiler the meaning of the keywords. All the keywords in C programming languages must be written in small case. All keywords must be written in small case. There are total 32 keywords available in C programming language. Some of the keywords are listed here. So there are total 32 keywords in C programming language. For the first session, just we'll see what are different keywords available in C. The first keyword written here is auto, second is register, static, extern, constant. Then the keyword that we use for data types like integer, character, float, double, void, long, short, signed, unsigned, default, break. These are jumping statement, break, continue, go to. Then we have decision control statement like if, else, switch case. Then we have loop control statement like for, while, do. Then we have union, structure, enum, size of, volatile and typed. There are total 32 keywords available in C programming language. All the keywords, if you see, all keywords are written in small case. C programming language is a case sensitive language. That's why there is a difference between capital A and small a. It means there is a difference between capital letters and small letters. We can use these two letters as two different variables in the same program. You cannot use any keyword name. You cannot use any keyword name as the variable name. Like I cannot write int space int semicolon. It means that first int was the data type, second int that you considered is the variable name, and semicolon figure. This will not work because integer is the keyword available in C programming language. Any keyword cannot be used as the variable name. Okay, so that you have to keep into the mind. Now the next topic, that is data types available in C programming language. What are the different data types we have in C programming language? We have four fundamental data types in C. That is character, integer, float and double. You have to remember all the four data types, that is character, integer, float and double. Remember this table given in the notes. I have arranged all the data types according to the memory required by the data types. Okay. So the first data type that we have in C programming language is character. Second is integer, third is float, fourth is double. Now what do you mean by a data type in C program? The data type tells the compiler about what type of values we will going to store in a variable. It tells the compiler that what type of value we are going to store in a variable. Now what is the use of character data types in a program? If you declare any variable as character, it is basically used to store characters. The format specifier that we need to specify in the program for character variable is %c. The range of values allowed for character data type is -127 to +128. Now a question may comes into your mind that basically we use character for storing character, but why the range of values are in numbers? These are basically nothing but the ASCII values for every character available on the keyboard. The ASCII value for capital A is 65, capital B is 66 and so on. Okay. Similarly up to Z, and special characters have some different ASCII values. So these numbers -127 to +128 represents the ASCII values of the characters available on the keyboard. Now what is the use of integer data type? Integer data type in C programming language is basically used to store integer values, that is decimal values. No floating point number or real number can be stored into integer data type. If a variable is declared as integer, it can only store the real part, okay, decimal part. And the format specifier that we use for storing integer numbers are %d. And the range of values allowed in any integer variable in C program is -32,767 to 32,768. positive. So any number in this range can be stored into an integer variable. Now we have another data type, that is float. What is the use of float data type in a C program? Float data type is basically used to store real numbers which has both the part, that is decimal and the fractional part. A real number consists of decimal as well as fractional part. The format specifier that we need to store floating point variable is %f, and the range of values allowed in float data type variable is 3.4e⁻³⁸ to +3.4e⁻³⁷. Now a question may comes into the mind that how much memory this type of variables will going to store. Character require 1 byte of memory, integer requires 2 bytes of memory, float requires 4 bytes of memory for a variable. Now there is one more data type available in C, that is double. The use of double data type is also to store real values. The format specifier used for storing a double number is %lf, and the range of values allowed in double data type is 1.7e⁻³⁸ to 1.7e⁻³⁸. Any value in this range can be stored into double variable. Now a question may comes into your mind that what is the difference between float and double? Both are basically used to store real values. Now there is a difference between float and double data type, that is the memory required for float is 4 bytes, whereas the memory required by double variable is 8 bytes. Second thing is, by default float data type can give you the accuracy up to 6 digits, whereas double will give you the accuracy up to 14 digits. It means after decimal point in float data type you can display 6 digits, but in case of double it displays 14 digits after the decimal point. So this thing that you have to remember, okay, about float and double. Now we'll see how to declare variables in a C program. Rules for naming a variable. How to give name to the variable? The first rule is it always starts with the alphabet. Every variable name must start with an alphabet. No special symbol is allowed except underscore in a variable name. C is a case sensitive language, so there is a difference between a small letter and a capital letter. Hence small a and capital A are two different variables in a C program. The next topic is how to declare a variable in a C program. This is the syntax that we use to declare any variable in a C program. What do you mean by syntax? It is a rule to declare a variable in C program. So we need storage class, then data type, variable 1, variable 2, comma karke hum log, we can declare n number of variables on the same line, and at last we give semicolon to terminate this line. If the storage class is not specified in this declaration, then by default the storage class is auto. So these are some of the examples given here of variable declaration. If you see the first example, integer a comma b, this line not only declare variables a and b, it tells the compiler that this a and b can store any integer value into it. Okay. Another variable is rate of interest. This is only one variable, but it has three different words, rate of interest. So all these three words are combined with the help of underscore. So with the help of underscore, we can consider this three words as a one word, and this can be given as a name to the variable. Then next declaration is character ch. It declares a character variable. And this is the fourth type of declaration for double variables. So x, y, z are double type of variables. So till this point, if you have any doubt, you can ask me into the chat room, or you can raise your hands by clicking the hand raise button. I I think there are no doubts. Thank you for watching the video.